Oh, hey, chef, I'm gross and I tucked my t-shirt into my pants. Said you wanted to see me?
His name is Matt, and please, just sit down.
Oh, okay, because we're missing one lobster fork, and I just started interrogating the staff about it.
It's just one fork. It'll turn up.
Actually, where were you last night?
Owen, stop. You've received another complaint, and as you know, corporate policy dictates that this meeting will be recorded for your protection and ours.
Oh, I knew it. Marcus told you I was showing him old videos of prisoners dying in electric chairs. He told me he liked how their eyes popped out.
What?
But now I'm thinking that was a setup.
No, Marcus never told me you were watching snuff films at work. Stop that.
Is it because they died? What if I had some videos of people getting electrocuted, but they don't die?
Just shut up. Sorry, we're recording. What I mean to say is that this complaint is from Dave, the delivery guy.
Oh, the motel man.
No, I said his name is Dave, and I just got word that you followed him in your car back to his house.
That's just it. It wasn't his house. It was the Pegasus Motel.
Well, why is he saying you were at his house?
Well, I was, eventually.
Okay, I feel like you've crossed some serious boundaries here, and you don't even know it.
Well, I had reasons to believe that he was crossing some boundaries. Have you ever been to the Pegasus Motel?
No.
Well, me neither, because that's where people go to have affairs. Trust me, that winged horse has seen some shit.
Owen, I'm not paying you to be a private investigator.
Maybe we can talk about that.
No, because you're a dishwasher. Seafood restaurants don't have their own PIs.
You're telling me Red Lobster doesn't have a PI? Okay, then. How do they know if their delivery guys are having affairs?
They don't, because it's none of their business, just like it's none of yours. Why would you even think it was okay to do something like this?
Because I had my suspicions. Check it out. Just as I was getting into my car to head home the other night, I heard him on the phone making kissy noises, and I thought, wait, isn't he married? Nobody makes kissy noises with their wife. That's a new girlfriend move. And then I saw the wedding ring. Ah! He's having an affair!
Yeah, again. Absolutely none of your business.
I'm not done. I followed him, and sure enough, he went straight to the Pegasus Motel, where he met a woman with pink hair, and they disappear into room 15 together from exactly 6:49 to 9:37 p.m.
Wait, you staked out a motel room for 3 full hours?
Yeah, I was on the case. The next day, I followed him to his house, and I rang the doorbell.
You what?
When he came to the door, I asked for his wife. When he said, why, I said, I just needed to check if she has pink hair. And he got really mad, and I guess he called you.
Yeah, because that's nuts. I can't believe you did that. I mean, what did Claudia say about this?
Story's not done. As I'm arguing with the motel man on his porch, Claudia sneaks out of the car and peeks in the side window and sees the wife. She's a brunette, by the way. Now do you get it? We're obviously dealing with a very bad man.
I don't care what kind of guy you think he is. You need to apologize.
Wait, you're still gonna buy bread from this pervert?
Yes, Owen. He always brings it on time and it's excellent.
Well, that's true. I've never heard a complaint about his bread before. But doesn't it change things now that we know he can't keep his little baguette in his pants?
Jimmy Lobster's contract is with the bakery, not with Dave or his little baguette. So no, it's not our problem.
Wow, okay. Jimmy Lobster has all these fancy corporate policies, but no morals, I guess.
Well, I certainly wouldn't say no morals. There's plenty of corporate...
Let me put it this way. If you saw this in a movie, you'd think your character didn't have any integrity at all.
Okay, I'm pretty sure nobody's going to make a movie about this.
Nobody? Okay, because I put a few thoughts down on paper and they were starting to feel pretty good.
Owen, I need you to acknowledge for me and everyone listening to this recording that what you did was wrong so we don't have this problem again.
It's called cool dishwasher versus the motel man.
Owen, acknowledge what I said. Say it back to me. It's wrong to...
Okay, maybe just the motel man.
Owen!
Fine, I'll stop following the motel man everywhere he goes. But I'll tell you this. I'm not gonna let your bad attitude stop this movie from being made.